Sir, thank you for your time.
Yeah.
40 years of experience, more than 18,000 surgery cases under your belt. How does it feel?
Yeah, it's nearing 20,000 now. It's 19,800.
Awesome.
And, well, it's a lifetime achievement to you, if you can say that, because I've done nothing else but cardiac surgery
right.
all my life.
Right.
I have, to the extent, I have not devoted enough time to my family also.
But you have helped a lot of families to, you know, gain their family back.
Yeah, I think so. Yeah, it is a very satisfying line. There is no doubt about that.
Sir, we have come here today to get some insight into hypertension.
Yes.
It is emerging as a silent killer.
Yes.
And if we go by the data which we get thrown on our face, around 1.8 billion people worldwide is suffering from this disease. And a lot of people don't even know they are suffering. And that indomitable human mind does not allow the rest who know to take proper care of themselves. So before we get into any discussion, sir, what is hypertension?
Well, you see, the definition of blood pressure is taken by what they record in millimeters of mercury. It is the lateral pressure exerted by the blood fluid dynamics
right.
on the walls of the... So if the pressure is continuously high, the arteries on which they exert this lateral pressure, they get hardened. And that relates to a lot of problems, secondary organ damage.
Right.
So it is very important that we control the blood pressure. Coming to the question, what is normal blood pressure? Today we take 120 by 80 millimeters of mercury as a normal blood pressure. Anything above this is considered as hypertension. All hypertension doesn't need to be treated.
Right.
And it depends on the degree of hypertension that really... We are worried about hypertension only because it's a precursor to many other diseases.
Right.
Like heart disease, like cerebrovascular disease, like kidney disease, and also retinal disease.
Right.
That is why we try to control hypertension.
So basically one problem leads to an ecosystem of problems that
yes.
which needs to be taken care of and people need to understand.
You know, if you like, God designed this body to work optimally at 120 by 80 millimeters of mercury as we grow into adult life with all our adult activity. But if we try to work with, say, 150 by 90 or something like that, then you are straining the system.
Right.
Everything is not used to the same kind. It's just like when you are at home and you are getting 220 volts, everything works fine. Your AC is working fine, your radio is working fine, your TV is working fine. Suppose they suddenly give you 300 volts. Then things start conking off
right.
and they get burnt out. And that's what is happening with hypertension.
Doctor, before we get into the causes and the symptoms, I would like to know, is there a linkage with age? Is it 120 by 80 for all ages?
Well, you see, as we grow old, our arteries will become hardened. And now we attach a lot of importance to medial thickening, as we can estimate in the carotids. So, older we get, the blood pressure will tend to remain higher. There have been a lot of talk that lower the blood pressure, better it is. But then we discount it with the age. As we grow older, we allow the body to accept a higher blood pressure. Like for instance, if you send me a patient who is 45 years old and he has got 150 by 90, I would like to treat him. But if you send me a 75-year-old with 150 by 90, I will not treat him very drastically because his body system has got used to a higher blood pressure.
Right.
And you need that high blood pressure to perfuse the various organs.